Today our topic is Euler Lagrange and Newton Euler formulations. Euler Lagrange formulations are those which use energy based principles to get the equations of motion, whereas Newton Euler formulations are based on the vectors used to obtain the equations of motion of the system. Here the system means the robot. So, here are the announcements, outlines of lecture 18, that is today lecture is already uploaded. Also, I have uploaded the figures of chapter 8, and today the following students will come in front of the camera, not 10:25, these will be accordingly. So, we are starting 10:30, 10:45, 11:45, 12:10. So, at 12:10 your time, just like we started doing it for other lectures. So, for those who are present, we will come in front. To have a review of our last lecture, I just wanted to mention that we could not cover the one which we planned, 45 minutes were lost due to link problem. However, we started with the topic of dynamics, where I defined mass and inertia matrix and also the important concept of generalized coordinates and generalized force, and then I told you what is the Euler-Lagrange equation of motion. So, today's outline is examples of the Euler-Lagrange formulations. We will see two simple examples, one link arm and two link revolute arm. Then we will see the how Newton-Euler equations are written. Newton's equations are used for linear motion, Euler's equation for rotational motion. Then we will see the recursive Newton-Euler algorithms with examples, and finally the summary. So, we will go back to the incomplete portion of lecture 17. So, here the Euler-Lagrange equations of motion is given by d dt of del L del q y dot minus del L del q y is equal to phi I. L is called the Lagrangian. It is an energy which is kinetic energy T minus potential energy. Okay. Then q I is the generalized coordinate here, q y dot is the generalized speed, and phi I is the generalized force. Again, to remind you, generalized force is the one which is required to have a motion to give generalized coordinate or displacement q i. Okay. So, kinetic energy and potential energies can be expressed in terms of the Cartesian velocities. This is the linear velocity of the mass center of any body, and I is the inertia matrix of any body about its mass center. Omega I is the angular velocity of the ith body, and then we calculate the potential energy is C I is the mass center position transpose G, the gravitational vector. Okay. I think let us take an example. Here I wanted to point out last class which I have uploaded, there is a small mistake here in this expression, which I have corrected and uploaded again yesterday night. So, lecture 17, if you have uploaded in, if you have downloaded in the previous class, please download again. There is a small mistake here. So, today's 17 lecture you should download. So, let us take this example and do it systematically. So, this is the example we are talking about, a simple pendulum, or we call it a one link arm. So, I have this rigid link here which is connected with a revolute joint, This has a length A, mass center located at C. We can assume for simplicity that this C is at half of the distance. 1 minute. Okay, this C is at half of the distance. This is my x1 and y1. I have put it as per my DH definitions. This is my angle theta, which is angle between x1 and x2. To move this link, I need tau is the torque. Gravity is acting in these directions, okay, negative of x1. So, I need to now calculate the equation of motion for this one link system. Okay. So, that kinetic energy is obtained as half m a by 2 theta dot square plus half of m a square by 12 theta dot square. How it comes, I will show you doing it on the paper. So, this is my that system. So, I have a revolute joint here and then this is my link. I have an end effector here. Let us say this length is A. I am kind of redrawing what you have seen. So, then this is my x1, this is my y1, this is my fixed frame. As per DH definitions, I do this is my x2, then this is my y2. So, as per DH definition, this is my theta, actually theta 1, but since it is a one link, I am doing it at theta, and I need a torque tau to rotate this. Now, my Euler-Lagrange equation is del L del Q I dot minus del L del Q I is equal to phi I. Okay. Now, going back to our generalized coordinate, here I want to choose generalized coordinate. This is generalized coordinate is theta, because it has 1 degree of freedom. Okay. So, for 1 degree of freedom, I need one independent generalized coordinate. So, I put independent generalized coordinate is theta. So, for us q I is theta. Okay. And so, phi I is tau, because this is the generalized force causing this generalized transform, generalized rotations. Okay. So, now I calculate L, which is T minus U. T is given as half of M C transpose C dot transpose C dot plus half omega transpose I omega. Since I have only one body, I am not using the I and summation over I. Now, this is Cartesian velocity of C. What is C? C is sitting there. Okay. C is the mass center location, and this one, this is angular velocity of the link. Okay. So, this is the angular velocity of the link. Now, since I have chosen my generalized coordinate as theta, I should be writing this kinetic energy in terms of generalized coordinate. once I write in terms of generalized coordinate, then only I can apply this formula to do the partial differentiation here and the total time derivative here to get the final equation of motion for the one link system. So, now I need a relation between c dot and theta omega versus theta. Let us do this. So, relation. So, here relation with theta, okay, and then relation with theta. Okay. So, let us find out the relation with theta. So, first thing is, if this is theta and this, what is this point? I am considering this is at a half the distance. So, this is a by 2. Okay. Now, if you want to find out the time derivative of this thing, that is c dot, it can be done two ways. Number one, let us see what is this vector. This is my c vector, position of the mass center from the origin of the frame. So, c can be written as a by 2. So, a by 2 cos theta, a by 2 sin theta 0. So, c along x directions, it has this component, which is a by 2 cos theta. Along y, it has this component, which is a by 2 sin theta, and along z, it has 0. So, if I want to calculate c dot, so this will be c dot will be, let us do it in the other page. So, c dot will be minus a by 2 sin theta and theta dot. Okay. So, this is c here. So, I am calculating c dot, a by 2 is a constant term, cos theta the time with respect to theta is minus sin theta, and then it is a theta dot. If you are not convinced, let me write d dt of a by 2 cos theta is equal to a by 2 is a constant, then it will be del cos theta by del theta, and then d theta dt. So, del cos theta, del theta is minus sin theta. So, this is a part of our mathematical fundamentals. So, this is minus sin theta and this we write it as theta dot. So, same thing I have written, and that c dot is actually dc dt. Okay. So, in a similar manner, a by 2 sin theta, which will be a by 2 cos theta, theta dot, and this will be 0. Okay. So, but my interest is finding out c dot transpose c dot, right. So, c dot transpose c dot. Okay. Let us do it. C dot transpose will be minus a by 2 sin theta, theta dot. So, C dot transpose, which is rho matrix, a by 2 cos theta, theta dot 0. Okay. And then, okay, then C dot, this is minus a by 2 sin theta, theta dot, a by 2 cos theta, theta dot and 0. So, if you look at this, a by 2, which is a square by 4, this will be sin square theta, theta dot square, theta dot square. Next term plus a square by 4 c theta cos square theta, and then theta dot square. Okay. So, the final expression is a square by 4 theta dot square. Okay. So, this gives me c dot transpose c dot. Okay. I have here m c dot transpose c dot. So, this term I write in a different color now. So, this term now for this system, the top system here, for this system will become m a square by 4 theta dot square. Okay. So, the kinetic energy due to the linear motion c dot is m a square by 4 theta dot square, okay, which we go get from the derivations we have just done here, a square by 4 theta dot square. I put it here and I get it. I told you that this can be done in two ways. This is one way. What is the other way? I will show you the other way now before we do this expression. Okay. Now, the other way is our kinematic analysis. Velocity of this point, which is c dot, can be given as omega cross c. Omega is the angular velocity of this body cross this vector. What is omega? Omega I can write theta dot this dot multiplied by e. In kinematic analysis, we have seen this kind of relations. Now, I write omega in the fixed frame, which is frame number 1. This is my fixed frame, frame 1 is equal to theta dot. What is E in fixed frame? E in fixed frame. During our physical meeting in Addis Ababa, we have seen this is nothing but K in 1, which is equal to 0, 0, 1. Okay. So, theta dot E is equal to theta dot 0, 0, 1. What is c? C we have just seen c in 1 means this frame will be equal to a by 2 cos theta, a by 2 sin theta and 0. Okay. So, c dot can be calculated as omega 1 cross c in 1. To remind you, this bracketed means I am representing in the coordinate frame 1. So, omega will be 0, 0 theta dot, which is this one, cross a by 2 cos theta, a by 2 sin theta 0. This will give you minus a by 2 sin theta, theta dot, a by 2 cos theta, theta dot and 0. And after that it is the same, because c dot we also calculated here, c dot also we have calculated. So, c dot we can calculate from the expression of c, which is, let us put it 1 here, from the expression of C in the fixed coordinate frame and then do the time derivative to get it, or we can use this kind of kinematic relation that C dot is omega cross C, and then writing individual vector in their own coordinate frame and also get it. So, in a way we got the kinetic energy. So, kinetic energy due to linear motion is equal to half of m a square by 4 theta dot square. Okay. Now, we will be interested with kinetic energy due to rotational motion. Okay. This is linear motion. Now, we will do the rotational motion to compute these portions. Let us do that now. So, kinetic energy due to rotational motion is equal to half of omega transpose I omega. You have to be little careful here about these expressions. Okay. If you have doubt, you should stop me there and then itself. Omega in 1, we have just seen this is 0, 0 theta dot. I is mass moment of inertia with respect to mass center. Mass center C. Okay. This I definition has been given in the last class. I told you for all practical purposes for this course, this will be generally given to us. Somebody will calculate and will give to us. Let us say this is given as Ixx, Ixy and Ixz, Iyx which is equal to Ixx, these two are equal, Iyi and Iyz, Izx, Izy and Izz. Now, you must be scared that these two are equal. You must be scared, no, that in a practical situation, how will you calculate all those? And even though somebody gives it, no, what will be the physical understanding? But for planar case, this is the one which will be important. For planar motion. This term will appear. So, for planar case only this term will appear. How? Let us do it here. So, first I need to calculate I omega. So, if this is I and if I multiply with omega here, and I take with respect to first frame 0, 0 theta dot. If you multiply the result will be Ixx into 0, Ixy into 0, Ixz into theta dot. So, the first term is Ixz theta dot. Okay. The next one Iyx 0, Iyy 0, Iyz theta dot. So, this is I y z theta dot, right. Next one I z x 0, z y is 0, z z theta dot, I z z theta dot, okay. So, I omega is equal to this, but our kinetic energy is omega transpose I omega. So, I have to pre-multiply omega transpose. So, let us do this thing. So, let us pre-multiply omega transpose, which will be 0 theta dot. This means I am pre-multiplying this omega with this. So, the final result from here will come out to be 0 into this 0, this into this 0, only this will into this. So, this is equal to I z z theta dot square. So, this expression will become half I z z theta dot square. Okay. Now, what is I z z? We will go back to the figure which I have drawn at the beginning to tell you what is I z z. Now, this is our figure. What is the meaning of I matrix? Is the inertia matrix about the mass center here, C. Inertia matrix about the mass center C here, okay, in which I z z means moment of inertia about z axis passing through C. I will write it for you here. I z z is mass moment of inertia, okay, about z, okay, passing C. So, I z z means mass moment of inertia about z passing C, which means this line. This line. So, moment of inertia about this pen here, okay, passing through C. So, if you go back to your strength of materials book or theory of machines book, so mass moment of inertia about this pen passing through this can be written as m a square by 12. I z z means mass moment of inertia about z passing C can be given as m a square by 12. M is the mass of this link, m is the mass of this link, A is the length and m square by 12. So, I z z is m square by 12. This one now I will substitute in my expression. So, we have calculated here I z z. So, this should be is equal to m square by 12 theta dot square. Okay. So, now my kinetic energy due to rotational motion is given by, so this will be given by half m a square by 12 theta dot square. So, in a way this will be m a square by 24 theta dot square. So, let us go back to our kinetic energy expression. I will use the green. So, just like this one can be written as m a square by 12 theta dot square. Okay. So, m a square by 12 theta dot square. For your convenience, I will rewrite this kinetic energy in a fresh page. So, the kinetic energy T is half m a square by 4 theta dot square plus half m s square by 12 theta dot square. So, this is the total kinetic energy due to linear motion, due to rotational motion. If you add them together, it will become half. If I add these two now, m a square, so this will be by 3 theta dot square. So, if you add these two term, it will be m a square by 4 plus m a square by 12 will be m a square by 3 theta dot square. So, that gives me now the kinetic energy. What about potential energy? Let us do the potential energy. So, U is the potential energy, which was given as in our expressions, in our transparency, which we have seen, was minus m c transpose g. Okay. So, let us have c, which is the mass center location here, which was given as C is given as a by 2 cos theta, a by 2 sin theta, then 0, g g g is the gravitational vector, which is here g, it is acting in the positive x directions. So, this is acting in the positive direction. So, actually g is the acceleration due to gravity, 0 and 0. So, m u will be calculated as minus m c transpose g, that means this will multiply with this, this will multiply with this, and this will multiply with that. So, this will give minus m c is a by 2 cos theta and g. And so,
hello.
Yes.
C transpose is it?
C transpose?
Yeah.
This is C. So, C transpose will be.
No.
What is the question?
Vector C. Vector C, the transpose.
No, C transpose vector G. So, let us do it. C transpose.
That's right.
Right, C transpose G. Let me do it for you. A by 2 cos theta, A by 2 sin theta, 0, G 0, 0. So, this gives you A by 2 cos theta. And since minus m comes here. So, that is your the kinetic the potential energy, and this is your kinetic energy. But I think that in the expressions which I provide to you in the slides has different expressions. U in the slide has given as m g a by 2 minus a by 2 cos theta. So, there is some mismatch. Now, that is because when I write P E potential energy as minus m c g, let me write it like this. assumes G is in negative Z. I will write it for you again so that you can keep a note. U is equal to minus M C transpose G assumes G acting along negative Z direction, okay. But in our case, in the present case, G is acting in some different, G is acting in positive X. So, this is not valid, the one which I have given in the transparency, not valid for one link example. So, for the one link example, we take separately. So, we take separately like this. We know kinetic energy is equal to mg into height from 0 potential energy. Now, when is the 0 potential energy for this case? When the link is here, mass center is here, this is 0 potential energy. So, this distance here is a by 2, and when it goes to certain height here, so this distance is a by 2 cos theta, okay. So, this is 0 potential energy here. So, height is only this much. So, this is the height, and that is equal to a by 2 minus a by 2 cos theta. So, my potential energy is equal to, potential energy should be equal to m g a by 2 minus a by 2 cos theta. So, little caution here, this expressions is valid if I write g is in the negative z directions, otherwise you have to look at the examples carefully and apply our old knowledge, m g height from 0 potential. In this case, 0 potential is here, and when it moves, it has raised to some height here, and that is a by 2 cos theta, and from 0 potential the height is a by 2 minus a by 2 cos theta. So, that is why I am putting potential energy is equal to mg a by 2 minus a by 2 cos theta. So, with these two expressions now, kinetic energy and potential energy, I can now write Lagrangian L is equal to half m a square by 3 theta dot square minus m g a by 2 1 minus cos theta. So, now I get the Lagrangian expressions as L equal to half m a square by 3 theta dot square minus m g a by 2 1 minus cos theta, okay. So, after obtaining this, I can apply the Euler-Lagrange equations to get the final equation of motion for this one link system. We will do that next. So, what is our equation of motion? Okay, let us do it. So, we have del L del theta dot okay, that is the first term. So, this we can write half, this is a constant term m square by 3. So, this will be 2 theta dot, because this is the term, this is a constant term, constant. So, del theta dot 2 theta dot. Here there is no theta dot term. So, this will be simply 0. So, which I do not write. So, I cancel out these two. So, I write m a square by 3 theta dot. But then I have to do d dt of this, d dt of this. So, since this is a constant term, so d dt of whole thing, this is a constant term, and so this will be a double dot. So, m a square by 3 double dot. Now, then del L del theta, first term there is no theta term. So, this will be 0 minus, there is a theta term, m g a by 2, this will be 0, cos theta will be minus sin theta. So, this will be sin theta. So, the whole expression becomes minus m g a by 2 sin theta. So, del L del theta becomes minus m g a by 2 sin theta. So, now I can write the complete expressions d dt del L del theta dot minus del L del theta will be equal to m a square by 3 theta double dot, this minus and this minus will be plus m g a by 2 sin theta. So, this should be equal to phi. Phi means generalized force. What is the generalized force here? Who causes this displacement theta? Tau. So, this should be equal to tau. So, I write m a square by 3 theta double dot plus m g a by 2 sin theta will be equal to tau. So, this equation, this Euler-Lagrange equation, we call it equation of motion. Suppose if tau equal to 0, that means no force is applied here. If the no force is applied here, this is a situation of, say this pane is hinged here, okay. If it is under gravity, so then what will happen? This will move. This will move like this. This will move. If I hinge it here, okay. So, then it will move like a pendulum. Sorry, let us draw the figure for you. If I have a pendulum here, if there is no torque is applied, tau equal to 0, but gravity is here. So, what will happen? This will go to these directions and it will move like a pendulum. So, the system is a pendulum. Now, for a pendulum, if I have not derived the Euler-Lagrange equations, I can obtain from my undergraduate knowledge that for a pendulum, the equation of motion is the inertia about this point O. So, inertia about O theta double dot is equal to the torque applied on it. So, this is my G. So, the force applied on it is m G. So, the torque applied on it is m g. So, this distance, this is a by 2 sin theta. So, a force applied on it is minus m g a by 2 sin theta, because this m g will cause a torque this way, which is negative, which is this is negative of z. So, the torque about z. So, and what is the moment of inertia about end point of a link? This we can again from a table of theory of machine book, this is m square by 3. About this, this is m square by 12, about this, this is m square by 3. So, now if tau equal to 0, equation of motion from fundamental knowledge, from UG, UG means undergraduate mechanics course, if tau equal to 0, then this is the equation of motion, equation of motion. Now, if you look at what we derived m square by 3 theta double dot plus m g a by 2 sin theta equal to tau. So, if you make tau equal to 0, you get back to this equation. So, what we obtained from Euler-Lagrange equation gives rise to the same equations which we know from our undergraduate mechanics course. So, what we have done is then correct. So far using the example of single link, I have shown you how to derive the equation of motion for a single link case. If you have any doubts, please ask me, because otherwise I will show you another little complex equation of motion. In the meantime, you can also look at the expressions which I have derived on the slide. So, come back to the slide. So, here I have done kinetic energy T is due to linear motion, due to rotational motion, this U the potential energy, and this one d dt of del L del theta dot and del L del theta, and finally, I have shown you what is the equation of motion. This is the equation of motion for the single link case. If there is no question, let us try to complicate the problem for a two link case. So, the two link case, so this is my link number 1, this is my link number 2. As per our DH parameter notation, this is my x 1, this is y 1. Similarly, for the others, only this is theta 1. This will be theta 2. Kinetic energy is equal to summation over I equal to 1 to 2 half of m I c I c I dot plus half of omega I transpose I I omega I. Again, this is, so I have to find out the kinetic energy of this body, I have to find out the kinetic energy of the second body, then add it together. So, let us do systematically. Let us first find out T 1, which is kinetic energy for body number 1. For this, it will be half of m1 c1 dot transpose c1 dot plus half of omega 1 I1 omega 1. What is c1? It will be like our single link case. So, c1 is equal to a1 by 2. Let us see, this length is a1 cos theta, which is this length, this length, because we are doing c is here, a 1 by 2 sin theta 0, c 1 dot will be minus a 1 by 2 sin theta, theta dot, a 1 by 2 cos theta, theta dot 0. So, the first term will be c 1 dot transpose c 1 dot will be a 1 square by 4 theta 1 dot square, theta 1, theta 1, theta 1, theta 1, theta 1, theta 1. So, this term c 1 dot transpose c 1 is given here as a 1 square by 4 theta 1 dot square. For this term, you can verify this will be m 1 a 1 square by 12 theta 1 dot square. Similar to 1 degree of freedom. This we have done it in the previous example. Okay. So, together kinetic energy can be written using the blue pen, green pen, is from here half m 1 a 1 square by 3 theta 1 dot square. This is similar to my single link case, not much of difficulties. For the second link, I will show you, this is little complex. So, first thing is, what is C2? C2 is this vector with a different color. This is my C 2 here and this is my C 2 vector. If you take its component, this will be this component plus this one, here to here plus there to there, right. So, let me write, from here to here is a 1 cos theta 1, from the here to here plus a 2 by 2 cos theta 1 2. So, this distance will be a 2 by 2 cos theta 1 plus theta 2, which we are writing as theta 1 2. Then the second term, a 1 sin theta 1 plus a 2 by 2 sin theta 1 2 and the last term is 0. So, if you do C 2 dot, I am doing slowly, a 1 sin theta 1 theta 1 dot. I just remove theta 1 here for simplicity of expressions, then minus a 2 by 2 sin theta 1 2 and then this will be theta 1 dot plus theta 2 dot. If you have difficulties, you can ask me in the next class, but these are the expressions, a 1 cos 1 theta 1 dot plus a 2 by 2 cos 1 2 theta 1 dot plus theta 2 dot and last one is 0. If you want to do now C2 transpose C2 dot transpose C2 dot, we know the C2 dot transpose C2 is this term square plus this term square, right. So, let us do the square together. First, the top one A1 square sin 1 square theta 1 square plus A2 square 4 sin 1 2 square theta 1 2, I write it like this, square plus twice of A1 sin 1 theta 1 dot A2 by 2 sin 1 2 theta 1 2 dot. A square plus B square plus 2AB, 2AB, right. Next one plus this one A1 square cos 1 square theta 1 dot square plus A2 square by 4 cos 1 2 square theta 1 2 dot square plus 2A1 cos 1 theta 1 dot A2 by 2 cos 1 2 theta 1 2 dot. Again A square plus B square plus 2 into A into B. These two terms together becomes A1 square theta 1 dot square. These two terms together will become A2 square by 4 theta 1 2 dot square, because it is sin square theta plus cos square theta plus these two cancels out, these two cancels out. So, I take A1 A2 theta 1 2 dot as common. So, A1 then I have A2 then I have theta 1 2 dot, then theta 1 dot. So, I should take theta 1 dot here. What remains are sin 1 2 plus cos 1 2. If you look at this expression using a cos identity, this is cos A cos B plus sin A sin B, which gives rise to cos A minus B, which is cos 2. So, our final expression is then what is shown here. So, C2 dot C2 is so this becomes our C2 dot transpose C2. If there is any difficulty here, you can ask me, otherwise, I will proceed to calculate my kinetic energy due to rotation. So, this is due to translation. Only thing I have left now is m2. If you multiply with m2, so you have to multiply here with m2 and the whole thing. So, this is the kinetic energy half. So, kinetic energy due to the rotation of the kinetic energy due to translational motion of the second link is given by the whole expression here. Let us do now the rotational motion. So, rotational motion is half omega 2 transpose I 2 omega 2. Let me quickly draw the link here. So, rotational motion omega 2 can be given as omega 1 plus theta 2 dot E 2. This we have done during our Jacobian derivations. So, if I want to do it like my previous system in frame 1, what is E 2? E 2 is here, which is equal to K 2. Okay. So, in 1, this we have already calculated 0, 0, theta 1 dot plus theta 2 dot, this will be 0, 0, 1. So, the total expression will be 0, 0, theta 1 dot plus theta 2 dot, which we are indicating as 0, 0, theta 1, 2 dot. Now, then this term will become half of 0, 0, theta 1, 2 dot, and the way we have done it earlier, it will be I 2 x, let me rewrite, half omega 2 transpose I 2 omega 2 can be given as half 0, 0, theta 1, 2 dot. This will be I 2 x z theta 1, 2 dot, I 2 y z theta 1 2 dot, I 2 z z theta 1 2 dot. And as I told you, for the planar motion only z z term comes into picture. So, if you do this multiplication, you can easily see this will be I 2 z z theta 1 2 z square. What is I 2 z z here? I 2 z z is the moment of inertia of the second link about an axis z passing through C 2, and this we know half m 2 a 2 square by 12 theta 1 2 dot square. So, any mass moment of inertia about an axis passing through its mass center is given by m a square by 12. So, now in totality, if I write my total kinetic energy, it will be as follows. So, kinetic energy T for two link system, for two link RR, first I write the for the first link, which is the big expression there, which I will write it for you. Okay, it is here. Okay. So, half, no, this is for the second link. I have to first look for the first link. First link, okay, half m 1 a 1 square by 3 theta 1 dot square, that is from the first link. From the second link, half m 2 a 1 square theta 1 dot square plus a 2 square by 4 theta 1 2 dot square plus a 1 a 2 theta 1 2 dot theta 1 dot cos 2, then plus half m 2 a 2 square by 12 theta 1 2 dot square. So, this is first link linear plus rotational, second link linear, second link rotational. Okay. So, if you notice here this term and if this term can be added, and this will get 3 here. So, I will remove this term. So, the total kinetic energy is given by half m 1 a 1 square by 3 theta 1 dot square plus half m 2 a 1 square theta 1 dot square plus a 2 square by 3 theta 1 2 square plus a 1 a 2 theta 1 2 dot theta 1 dot and cos 2. So, that is about the kinetic energy. Okay. For the time being, let us assume that this tooling is moving on a plane. For the time being, assume no g, because things are already complex and I do not want to complicate further. So, assume no g here. So, now I can calculate del t. So, now L t minus u. So, this is 0 for no g. So, L becomes t. So, del L del theta and del t del theta dot are same. So, del L del theta dot. So, now let us see which are the dependent terms. So, I have first term here half m 1 a 1 square by 3 2 theta 1 dot plus we come here half m 2 a 1 square 2 theta 1 dot this one here plus a 2 square by 3. Then from here this is 2 theta 1 2 dot this term. For your benefit, I want to show you how this becomes this. So, in a different color. So, del del t del theta del theta 1 2 dot square del theta 1 dot. Okay. This will be equal to 2 theta 1 2 dot then del L del theta 1 dot plus theta 2 dot. Now, since I am doing the partial derivative of theta 2 dot with this theta 1. So, this will be 2 theta 1 2 dot this portion will be 1. So, this is 1 plus 0. Okay. So, this is the reason I have written only 2 theta 1 2 dot. Okay. Proceed next. Next, I have this one here. So, plus a 1 a 2 a 1 a 2. So, theta 1 dot. So, this term is little complex. Okay. So, I can do it for you theta 1 2 dot cos 2 plus this will be theta 1 dot cos 2. I will do it for you this term. I will do it separately below. So, again del theta 1 2 dot theta 1 dot del theta 1 dot. Okay. What is this term? The top term is theta 1 dot plus theta 2 dot into theta 1 dot. Okay. So, del L. So, these two term is del of theta 1 dot square plus theta 1 dot theta 2 dot del theta 1. So, if you do these expressions, so this will be 2 theta 1 dot plus theta 2 dot. Okay. So, this term can be written as theta 1 plus theta 1 2 dot. Okay. Because I take 1 theta 1 dot plus theta 2 dot, this becomes this and theta 1. And that is the same thing appeared here theta 1 2 dot corresponding to this one and this theta 1 dot correspond to this. You see how things are very complex even for a two-link case. So far, I have not completed it. I have just only done del L del theta 1 dot is the total complete expressions. After that, I have to do ddt. So, for the Euler-Lagrange equations, from there, you have to do ddt of del L del theta 1 dot, okay. So, if you look at this expression now, what we will have is this 2 will cancel out and so forth. The first term will be m 1 a square by 3 theta 1 double dot. So, this term I have completed. Then the next term will be plus. So, this 2 and this 2 will cancel out. So, this will be m 2 a 1 square theta 1 double dot plus a 2 square by 3 theta 1 2 double dot plus a 1 a 2, this will be theta 1 2 double dot cos 2 minus theta 1 2 dot sin 2 theta 2 dot, because this is theta 2 function of time. Then plus theta 1 double dot cos 2 minus theta 1 dot sin 2 theta 2 dot. So, this is the one for with respect to theta 1 dot and then time derivative of that one. If I do del L del theta 1, okay. So, I have to look for the kinetic energy. So, here I have a kinetic energy. I see this is a function of theta 1 dot. So, del L del theta 1 is 0. Then the next one, no theta 1. So, again 0, no theta 1, again 0, and no theta 1, again 0. The whole kinetic energy is not a function of theta 1. So, I can write del L del theta 1 equal to 0. So, my first equation of motion, that means ddt of del L del theta 1 dot minus del L del theta 1 is equal to the generalized force, which is the torque 1. It should be equal to this term which I have written there, which I will now rewrite for you. So, the final equation of motion for the first link, for first joint, equation of motion will be m 1 a 1 square by 3 theta 1 double dot plus m 2 a 2 square theta 1 double dot plus a 2 square by 3 theta 1 2 double dot plus a 1 a 2 theta 1 2 double dot cos 2 minus theta 1 2 dot sin 2 theta 2 dot plus theta 1 dot c 2 minus theta 1 dot sin 2 theta 2 dot is equal to tau 1, okay. This is a wrong here, this bracket will be closing here. So, this bracket will be closing here. So, this is the first joint equation of motion. If you apply for the second joint in a similar manner, that means ddt of del L del theta 2 dot minus del L del theta 2, then you will get another expression which I am not calculating, I am not finding, okay, but you can calculate it, and then you will get an equation of motion similar to this one. So, first one, second one. So, we get two equations of motion for the 2 degree of freedom thing. So, we get two equation of motion for 2 degree of freedom r. If you do this thing, then we can systematically arrange. Once you have written these two, I can systematically arrange in the following manner. So, systematically arranging and then I can write I11, I12, I21, I22, θ1" θ2" plus H1 and H2 is equal to τ1, τ2. And in a we write I θ" plus H⃗ is equal to τ⃗. So, this is a standard form, standard form for the robot's dynamic equation of motion. And we also call as a dynamic model. So, they are equated with a dynamic equation of motion. So, dynamic model is equated with the dynamic equations of motions. Now, you must be wondering then, what are these I11, I12? By the way, I12 is equal to I21, because this I matrix is symmetric. You may remember in the last class, I told you that inertia matrix for a rigid body is a symmetric, inertia matrix for a system is also symmetric. In this case, this is called system inertia matrix. So, this I is called systems, in this case robots inertia matrix, or generalized inertia matrix, in short we call it GIM. Okay. What about H? H is called as vector of Coriolis and convective inertia terms. Which are those? These are squares of velocities. So, this is I is the inertia term, mass length of different links multiplied by joint accelerations. Here you will have mass length and velocity squares, maybe θ1 dot square or θ2 dot square, and theta 1 dot, theta 2 dot, etc., they are equal to tau 1. These expressions are available in the book. I will also show you in my slide now. We go back to the slide. So, this gamma is corresponding to the gravity, which I have ignored while calculating it. So, gamma did not appear, but if you consider the gravity, then it will be coming like this. I 11 is m1 a1 square by 4 plus I 1 z z, which is our m1 a1 square by 12. So, if you add these two, it will become m1 a1 square by 3. Similarly, m2 a1 square, a2 square by 4, a1 a2 cos 2. This term is m2 a2 square by 12. So, these two together will become m2 a2 square by 3. So, the first term, the I11 is shown here. I12 and I21, they are equal. They will be given by this, and I22 will be given by that. Okay. So, actually the second equation will come out to be simpler one, but the first equation is difficult, because if you look at my hand, the second link is rotating about the first link. So, this will be like our single link equation of motion, very simple. m2 a2 square by 3, theta 2 double dot. Okay. But the this one will be carrying the first link rotation plus this link rotations also. So, that is why the first equation of motion for the first joint, this one will be rather complex compared to this one. That is why you find in the expressions that I22 coming out to be simpler, I22 coming out to be simpler than I1. What about H1 and H2? So, H1 is minus M2 A1 A2 sin theta 2. This is the thing I was talking about, that square terms. So, theta 1 dot, theta 2 dot and theta 2 dot square. These terms are called the Coriolis terms. Why they are Coriolis? I will tell you. H2, as I told you, the second equation will be simpler. So, H2 will be simpler like this. Since we have not considered gravity, so in our derivation it will not come, but if you consider, it will come like that. Okay. So, these verifications will take as an assignment maybe. I will formally announce in the next class, but please try to understand what I have done in today's class, so that if there is any difficulty, I can explain before I give the assignment to you. So, that was basically the continuation of my last class. So, today I think there is no time to propose the Newton-Euler equations, but I will just explain the meaning of Coriolis, okay, before I bring you in front of the camera. So, Coriolis in dynamics, what does it mean? You have seen theta 1 square, theta 1 dot, theta 2 dot, they are called the Coriolis term. Physically, this Coriolis accelerations, you have come across this terminology, Coriolis acceleration, in your undergraduate theory of machines class. Physically, if you want to understand, this is as follows. If you go to the park, amusement park or any park where you have merry-go-round, right? When the merry-go-round is rotating, if you try to walk along the radius, okay, suppose if you want to go towards the center or coming out of the center, when it is rotating, the person will experience a force sideways. So if you look at me, then I will show you how it happens. So if I am walking towards the center, if I am walking towards the center while the thing is rotating, please look at me. So if this is the merry-go-round which is rotating like this, okay, and then you want to walk towards the center, or you want to walk towards the center while it is rotating, then you will have a sideways force, you will fall down, okay. So this is due to the Coriolis acceleration. So when something is rotating and then there is another thing which is translating, then due to the combination of this rotation and translation, there is a sideways force which will make you fall. If you have not experienced so far, please go to any park and experience the Coriolis force. So with this, I stop, and these things will come back in the next class. But now, if you have question, you ask me. Otherwise, everybody can leave except these 6 students who will come in the front and answer some questions of mine or ask me some questions. Yes, sir.
For 2 link case.
Yes.
We are calculating for link 1. We are calculating kinetic energy due to linear.
Right.
Not angular.
Right.
Why? It's not clear for.
Please repeat.
For 2 link case.
Right.
2 link.
Yes, 2 links.
We are calculating kinetic energy.
For both the links.
Kinetic energy.
Kinetic energy.
For 2 links.
Okay, let me bring.
Kinetic energy.
We are calculating kinetic energy for the first link as well as for the second link.
Yes, yes. For the first link.
Yes.
Only due to linear. Linear. We are calculating due to linear.
Linear as well as rotational. I'll show you. First joint equation of motion. One. Let me just find it out for you. Okay, let me show you on this thing. We are calculating for both. T is half m1 c1 transpose c1 plus half omega 1 transpose i1 omega 1. So this term will give you m1 a1 square by 4 theta 1 dot square, and this will give you m1 a1 square by 12 theta 1 dot square. So these two, when you add, it will give you half m1 a1 square by 3 theta 1 dot square. So when I wrote this one, this has both m1. So this is coming from m1 a1 square by 4 plus m1 by 12. So this is due to rotation, this is due to linear. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. If there is no other general questions, can I request these students to come in the camera, in front of the camera or in front of the mic, to ask me questions. Alemake Failu, Bereket Kebede, David Gudeta, Desalegen Siferau, Filago Vorku and Gebru Amare. Who are the absent students here? Can I see them in the front seat? Alemake Failu, raise your hand. Alemake Failu, I can't see you. You can come in the seat. Yeah, very good. Bereket Kebede. Okay, good. David Gudeta. Did I not ask you a question in the last class? Did I?
Yes, you
are. Okay.
Yes.
So, you are the repetition. Desalagen Siferau. Raise your hand. No? He is not here today? So, absent. Filagot Vorku. Okay, good. Gebru Amare. Okay, good. So, you have a question for me or should I ask you a question?
I have a question for you.
Please. Yeah.
What is the purpose of fourth illustrator?
What is? Please repeat your question.
Purpose of fourth. Calculating fourth illustrator.
How to calculate?
No. What is the purpose?
Okay.
To
what?
Calculate fourth illustrator.
Okay. Good question. The purpose is like if you are performing certain tasks, right? Suppose carrying certain weights, you should know where you should keep your workpiece. If you keep your workpiece here for my robot here, no, the force ellipsoid will become a straight line, okay, which will indicate that the robot is very sensitive and it cannot move in the front direction. So, the purpose of calculating force ellipsoid is before you design a robot, before you decide where the workpiece should be kept for certain tasks. If it is a circle, if this is my robot, okay, and you want to, the two purpose here, two purpose. First purpose for the design. If you know that certain task has to be performed in this zone, you can decide your link lengths corresponding to the force ellipsoid becoming a circle, and at that position, it is the most comfortable position for the robot to do with the minimum energy. It will do the task effectively. The second task is, given a robot, you now decide that you want to perform certain operations. Where to keep the work pieces? You should not keep the work here and you should not ask the robot to do the job in this way. You can try yourself doing the work. It will be very painful for you here, right? But if you do the job like this, it is very comfortable. At these positions, the force ellipsoid will become almost like a circle, indicating that this is a comfortable position. What can be done very comfortably. Others have okay. Others have questions.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Hello. Can you hear me?
Yes.
I have a general question.
Please.
Especially today's class.
Okay, good.
I just understand the whole thing about today's class. Especially example 2.
What did you not understand?
Example 2.
You did not understand the purpose of solving example 2. Is that right?
Yes.
Okay. The purpose of solving example. Did you understand the purpose of example 1?
No. I didn't say the purpose.
Okay.
So, think how to you derive.
How to?
You derive.
Okay. How to derive the U? from the starting point, okay. So, let me show you from the beginning. Okay, here I have. Let's go to the camera here. On my hand, okay. You see, the Euler-Lagrange equations given by this. Okay, let me show you the first page. Yeah. See, this is Euler-Lagrange equation of motion given in this form, right, where L stands for the Lagrangian kinetic energy and potential energy. This equation relates the force applied on a joint causing the motion Qi. In this case, the motion is provided by tau causing the displacement theta. This is a general expression provided by these two scientists, Euler-Lagrange, okay, in a very general fashion. For a particular example, if we want to apply, how to apply, these are the steps. The first step is, what is my generalized coordinate? I told you in the previous class, generalized coordinates are those which are used to define its complete configurations. In this case, Qi means theta. Okay. After I have defined that theta is my generalized coordinate, if I calculate Lagrangian in terms of kinetic energy due to linear motion and the rotational motion, which are given in different coordinate system, that means this is my Cartesian coordinate. But since my generalized coordinate is theta, I need to correlate, then only I can go and get the equation of motion. And the purpose of obtaining this kind of equation of motion is to use for control purposes. Suppose if you have a motor here, how much torque you need to apply to control your theta, and Euler-Lagrange equations gives a way to obtain that. So, to obtain this, I need to calculate L, I need to do this. I need to do this to come up with my final equation of motion, which is given by m s square by 3 theta double dot plus m g a by 2 cos theta is equal to tau. Is it little clear now?
It is very clear.
Okay. Okay, I think time is approaching. So, other students, I am not asking any questions. Good that I have two questions from the students. Another question for you?
No.
Okay. Thank you very much. By the way, tomorrow I will take the class at 9 o'clock Ethiopian Standard Time. And what has been slotted, my class on Thursday will be taken by somebody else. So, I will come back tomorrow to take the robotics class at 9 o'clock Ethiopian Standard Time. Okay? So, please inform your robotics friends. Yes.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much.